Hi, everybody, and welcome to another ICATER demo. I'm Amanda Lewis, one of the ICATER graduate assistants, and today I'm going to be showing you my very favorite tool. This is Dragon Naturally Speaking. Dragon Naturally Speaking is the gold standard right now for speech-to-text or dictation software and has been instrumental in my success as a student with learning disabilities in writing. So I'm really excited to get started. You can see up here at the top of my screen, I've got the Dragon Bar launched. So this is a feature of Dragon 13 as well as Dragon 14, the newest version. Since a lot of people are familiar with older versions of Dragon that looked a little different and also were a little harder to use, I'm going to actually go ahead and take you through the setup process so you can really see how easy it is to get a really excellent dictation experience quickly with the new versions of Dragon. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new profile. And it's just going ahead and getting that booted up for me. So I'm going to go ahead and hit new. And it's going to take me through this setup process. Let me make sure that my screen share is showing you what you want to see. I'm going to go ahead and switch so you can see that. Okay, so this is the tutorial that takes you through the setup process. I'm going to kind of blitz through it pretty quick. Alrighty, so now that I've named my profile, I need to make sure that I'm training Dragon with the audio device I'm actually going to be using. So every time you change a microphone, you have to go through a retraining process because, of course, every mic's going to record sound just a little bit differently, and that can make a big difference in how you sound to Dragon. So I'm going to make sure that it understands that I'm going to be using my Logitech USB headset. That's what I'm wearing right now. Good microphones do not need to be expensive. This was under $30 on Amazon. I've really been pleased with it. Few words on microphone selection while it's going ahead and getting my mic. It's really important to recognize there's two basic kinds of mics you might use. One's a headset mic like what I'm going to be using today. The other's a stand mic that's going to sit in front of you. If you're using a headset mic, you're going to want to make sure that that mic is 2 to 3 fingers away from the corner of your mouth, like I'm wearing right here. That's so puffs of air when you're speaking aren't hitting the microphone and making garbled noises that could really affect the sound quality. But you're still getting it nice and loud. I always tell my students to think of sound like a wedge coming out of your mouth, so all my good sound is still hitting that microphone, but the air isn't. If you're using a stand mic, you want it to be 1 to 2 feet in front of you, depending on how loud you speak. Again, because it's a little further away, you're not as worried about that puff of air, and you want it right in the middle so that wedge of sound is coming right at it. In terms of quality of microphone, like I said, a lot of money isn't necessary to get a good mic, although I do love the website Speech Gurus if you're looking for some recommendations on the very best in dictation quality microphones. The most important thing to recognize is whether you go with a headset or a stand microphone, you're going to want one with a USB connection. That's going to give you the best quality of sound. I do not recommend using built-in microphones for people who are using dictation frequently, although built-ins are getting a lot better and can work in a pinch. If you're going to try and dictate a paper, you're going to want a higher quality microphone that's really going to give you a better experience. It's going to be more accurate. So now that we understand how to select a microphone and how to use one properly for a good dictation experience, let's move on to the next part. This is the part where I actually train Dragon to my voice. So I'm given a prompt, some prompt text. I always tell people if you have a student who isn't reading fluently for whatever reason, maybe this text is a little too hard for them, it's A-okay to give them text that's at the appropriate level for them, or even to have them just speak fluently into the microphone. I've had students recite memorized poetry or song lyrics as long as they're not actually singing. Whatever they can do in a natural speaking voice is what you're going to want to have them do to train Dragon. So I'm going to show you just how quick this goes. I am reading this text out loud, clearly and naturally. I will continue to use this tone when I dictate with the product. Right now, I am giving Dragon a chance to adapt to my voice and audio environment. As I talk, Dragon is checking the quality of the audio input and adjusting some settings. Good audio input is essential for accurate speech recognition. To achieve high accuracy, I should maintain a consistent distance between my mouth and the microphone. I should also minimize background noise. Dragon's website contains more tips as well as short videos. I will read this text from the beginning until the complete prompt appears. I am reading this text out loud, clearly and naturally. I will continue to use this tone when I dictate with the product. Right now, I am giving Dragon a chance to adapt to my voice and audio environment. As I talk, Dragon is checking the quality of the audio input and adjusting some settings. Good audio input is essential for accurate speech recognition. To achieve high accuracy, I should maintain a consistent distance between my mouth and the microphone. I should also minimize background noise. Dragon's website contains more tips as well as short videos. Okay, so there you have it. That's how long it took. That actually took a little longer than I thought it would. My hypothesis is that I'm actually running Zoom to record this demo for you, as well as Dragon itself, as well as Microsoft Word, which I'll be using to demonstrate the tool in a minute, which is probably a little much to be asking my laptop to do. So the processing demand might have had something to do with that. It might have taken a little longer. I always say computers are like brains that way. They can get overwhelmed just like we can. Okay, so as you can see, that really didn't take that long to go ahead and get the prompt read. Now it has everything it needs to know to go ahead and set up my profile. One thing I skipped through, before it gives you that microphone thing, it will also ask you for your language and dialect. Since I'm a native English speaker with a typical American accent, I just went ahead and left it at the default. But you can change those if your student does have an accent or is going to be dictating in another language. I always say if you have to read to the bottom of the prompt when you're setting up your profile, start thinking there might be something wrong. And if you have to go all the way through twice, there is definitely something wrong with your microphone and you want to go back and make sure that Dragon's using the correct microphone and that your microphone is set up correctly in relation to you. Because the only times I've ever seen it take that long are when there's a true mechanical issue with a microphone that is not Dragon. Which is a far cry from the experiences that some users have had in previous versions of Dragon. I believe it was version 8 that was particularly notorious for taking a long time. So it's just going ahead and prepping my profile. Should be about ready. Okay, now it's just asking if I'm willing to send my usage data. I usually tell people not to send their usage data. That's really an unnecessary step that really just kind of compromises your privacy. I mean, Nuance appreciates it, and if you're okay with them knowing some stuff about how you're using Dragon, that's up to you. I personally am not comfortable with that, so don't feel guilty if you say, do not send my usage data, and we'll move right along. I particularly encourage that if your student is a young person. Okay, I will say Dragon has a phenomenal tutorial to walk you through beginning Dragon. So I'm not going to take you through that because that's my job today. But I do strongly recommend it if you're a new Dragon user. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this, and it's going to launch the tutorial, and I'll close that real quick. Okay, so you can see I've got my little learning center here. It can have some kind of nice cheat sheets for how to for some kind of common commands. So this can be nice as a student is learning how to use Dragon. They can kind of check in here. They can also say, what can I say, if they're not sure what kind of commands might be available, and Dragon would help them out there. We're not going to need the Learning Center because you've got me today. So I'm going to go ahead and close that. One less thing for my computer's brain to juggle here. So here we've got the Dragon bar. You can see that the button's red right now. That means the microphone is off and Dragon is not listening to what I'm saying. So if I want to dictate with the tool, I'm going to need to turn my microphone on. So let's go ahead and do that and dictate our first sentence. Welcome to the Dragon Naturally Speaking demo! Go to sleep. Okay, so you saw a couple different things there. You can see that it's pretty smart. It automatically capitalizes beginnings of sentences, so that's really handy for students who tend to forget that part. It's smart enough to know that it's Dragon Naturally Speaking, so it goes ahead and spells that all correctly, even with the Naturally Speaking run together. You also saw that I was able to use punctuation simply by speaking it. Dragon excels at being able to punctuate and format with spoken commands. I'm going to show you a little bit more of that in just a second. I also want to point out to you that you saw me use a command. When I say go to sleep, you can see that up here in my Dragon bar, the mic icon turns blue, and you can see that those little bubbles next to it are kind of going up and down. This means that my microphone is still listening to me, but it's not going to record and write down what I say. So this is a really useful thing if you're dictating and someone comes into the room, they really need to talk to you, you're dictating and then you need to stop and think and maybe talk out loud to yourself, you can put it to sleep and then easily turn the microphone back on with your voice using another command, which I'll show you in just a minute. So that's just a really nice way to be able to engage with your microphone. So let's dictate a little bit more. Wake up. New line. Dragon has a variety of benefits for writers, colon. New line. Easy to use. Make that bulleted. New line. Intuitive. Italicize that. Never misspells a word. Select easy. Choose one. Go to sleep. Okay, so you saw me do a couple of different things just then. You saw me use a couple different punctuation marks. You saw me put in a colon. This will really do any punctuation mark you want. You just say the name of it. It's important to say it with a couple other words next to it, though. Otherwise, it might think that you just want it to write the word. So if you just say colon, for example, it might think that you're trying to write about the body part. So go ahead and say it after another word. It's pretty good at using context to figure out what you mean. You saw me go ahead and put in some bullet points, really handy for making a list or preparing to outline. Make sure to check out my video on using Dragon for the entire writing process for more about that. You saw that I was able to italicize. I could have said bold or underline instead. And you also saw me go into the correction menu. Now, it didn't mishear easy. If it had misheard a word, I could say the same thing. I would say correct instead of select. I would say correct and then the word, and then that same menu would pop up and I would either select from that list the one that I want, or I would go in and say spell that, and I could either speak or type the word. To correct. Dragon is only as good as the information you give it, and it doesn't know it's made a mistake unless you tell it. So that's a really important part of using Dragon, is not to let mistakes just slide. I always tell kids, you have to train your Dragon. Otherwise, it gradually starts misunderstanding you more and more because it assumes that it's hearing you correctly. So as you can see, Dragon is pretty easy to use right out of the box. There's a lot of more advanced ways to use Dragon for navigation, for editing work, but this is really the basics you need to know in order to start dictating with Dragon. Stay tuned for another video where I walk you through using Dragon to help you through the entire writing process, from free writing to outlining to drafting to revising. Just the way I use it myself as a student. And of course, Nuance also offers a lot of really great resources for Dragon. As always, if you have questions and comments, feel free to get in touch with us via social media or through our email. I hope this has been an interesting and enjoyable learning experience for you. Have fun playing with Dragon. Until next time, have a great one.